Now, the Royal Tour has attracted plenty of fans already in New Zealand, from the lukewarm to the absolutely obsessed. Hilary sits firmly towards the latter. But I'm told today you found someone who was even more into the royals than you.
I certainly did, Jeremy. Lizzie Garlick's so dedicated that she's taken time off work to follow Harry and Meghan. And luckily for us both, we had Officer O'Leary and Officer Minogue from the hit TV show Wellington Paranormal to keep us in line.
She's royally obsessed, channeling the Duchess of Cambridge for a possible encounter with Harry and Meghan.
I love your podcast!
From the shoes to the engagement ring, earrings, then pants and top, it's all a nod to her.
Kate always wears this outfit when she goes on nautical engagements. I thought very fitting that we're at the Surf Lifesaving Club.
Fingers crossed.
The royals weren't the only famous faces on the beach.
Oh my goodness.
Hello.
It's Officers O'Leary and Minogue from Wellington Paranormal. Hi.
Hi, what's your name?
Hilary Barry. Hello. From Seven Sharp.
Pleased to meet you.
It's lovely to meet you.
Good
too.
Really?
I'm a big fan.
Cool.
Big great. Fan. How's the day going?
Oh, well, I mean, it's a big day, isn't it? You know, for Wellington, for Lyle Bay. We've really had to put all hands on deck for this one. Very big event. But on a day like this, when you've got at least, how many people do you think?
I did a rough head count. I think it was 67 here today.
67 people.
We've got a lot of super fans here, and I think sometimes that exuberance gets a bit over the top, possibly. Oh, so
absolutely. Again, it's a bit like sports fans, isn't it? You know, these people that love the Royals, they've got their flags, they're waving them willy-nilly. I mean, that can be quite dangerous.
We don't mind you being excited, but you just got to keep it down to a certain level, you know. Don't be over the top, just be Kiwis about it.
Yep.
Don't be gushy. No,
that's
gushing.
Right.
What would be considered over the top, do you think?
I mean, certain types of dress.
I mean, it's touch and go with that tiara, to be honest. But I can see that you're just trying to say, you know, trying to make the Royals feel at home, and I guess that's good. But anything more over the top than that might have been a bit much.
And you do have to be careful, because you can be done for impersonating a princess. It's actually finable and jailable offence.
Yeah.
You might get away with it today, but I would be very careful.
Well, it's not Lady Diana, is it? And that's the one she looks the most like. So
you do, actually.
Mm. Obviously she's not here, sorry.
We'll cut that bit out.
But you know, I promise to behave in the crowd.
Please do, yeah. Like I said, just be careful with that tiara. And those earrings as well. Just try not to get them caught in a flag. That could be very dangerous and painful.
Or in a baby's face.
Or on that dog's. Okay, thanks, guys.
Poor Lizzie. She didn't get to talk to Harry and Meghan today. But she's okay with that.
At least I got to meet them yesterday. I'm happy. I got a front row view of all the action. So, yeah, I'm happy.
And why wouldn't she be? Here's Lizzie yesterday as those royal dreams came true.
Oh, lovely Lizzie. You know, she waited 6 hours to see them yesterday and she absolutely was rewarded. I was trying to think of what or who I would wait 6 hours for, and I actually couldn't think of anyone.
I think a baby, perhaps, is maybe the only thing that you might wait 6 hours for.
Oh, good point.
Just getting back. So before, we saw that you were outside at Government House there when the fire alarm went off. And did you say you were wearing the same dress? Why are you wearing the same dress that you were wearing last night?
Well, it's just so pretty. And I felt like a princess. And I just, you know, I almost haven't taken it off since I wore it last night to Government House. Because it's just so gorgeous. So there you go. I thought I would just treat everybody to what I wore to the royal reception tonight.
Yeah. Okay, you've been going on and on about that for weeks. We have not. That's all we've been hearing about.